Module 6 Multipurpose Medium Thermocool. Eminent artist and painter Georges Braque has rightly said, "The starting point of a picture for any painter is a matter of colors and form." I believe that the poetry of art, if that is what one may call it, is a matter of animating these forms and colors. To make thermocool mural design, the first step is to take a drawing sheet of a size equal to the thermocool sheet size desired for the mural, because I am making the mural using geometrical shapes. I use a steel foot ruler for dividing the space of the sheet in different segments, and I mark the lines accordingly using a pencil. Here, mural design which is prepared is opting for formal balance. Thus, equal shapes are being drawn on this drawing sheet, leaving equal spaces on both sides and equal thin margins on the other two sides. After this is done, I draw circular lines in the corner on one side. I repeat this process a number of times and make these lines touch a horizontal line drawn near the middle of the drawing sheet. Then I darken the final lines and creating more circular shapes, one crossing over the other. I draw a few small circles in freehand in different sizes, including one in oval shape. According to eminent British author and speaker Ken Robinson, creativity is putting your imagination to work, and it's produced the most extraordinary results in human culture. Then I draw a wave-like line at the lower end of the drawing sheet and join it with the bottom of the circular lines. Now I add a small triangle and another triangular shape on the bottom line. Artists are free to use their imagination to draw such murals in different geometrical shapes. In this mural design, I divide different areas of the drawing sheet by drawing diagonal and straight lines so that the composition is balanced and the overall mural design interests the viewer. To show the areas which are to be carved out, I draw lines and darken the area. Such lines are also drawn in other portions as per the requirement of the design. The exercise is repeated in circular shapes also. The idea is to have balance of negative and positive spaces. In some areas, I draw some doodling lines to create textural value, as only straight lines will add monotony to the composition. Now we see that the mural design offers more aesthetic interest. The triangular shapes now look like mountains or hills. Around the small circles and oval shapes, I use the same doodling technique by drawing freehand lines, and the circles emerge permanently. According to Canadian journalist, author, and speaker Malcolm Gladwell, the visionary starts with a clean sheet of paper and reimagines the world. More straight lines are drawn in the triangular shapes to add compositional value and perspective. Now I finalize the final shapes by darkening the lines. At the same time, after pondering for a while, create pockets of design. You will find that the mural composition evolves slowly and organically while we keep on adding shapes and textures. Areas are darkened to add depth, which is later on to be carved on the thermocol sheet. Finalize the areas to be carved by repeatedly darkening the shapes. According to eminent British playwright, novelist and story writer W. Somerset Maugham, imagination grows by exercise and, contrary to common belief, is more powerful in the mature than in the young. An artist should attempt 3 or 4 drawing exercises before finalizing one composition which is interesting and well balanced and offers a good chance for carving out the shapes and elements in different textural designs. Now I take 2 rectangular thermocol sheets and join them in the center, and by using the steel foot ruler I cut out the extra thermocol sheet with a pointed cutter to make a square shape. Taking references from the original design, I draw the similar design on the thermocol sheet with the help of a pencil. Don't push the pencil too hard while drawing, as it will distort the shape of the element. You will find that this time it is easier for me to draw the mural design after taking references from the original mural design drawn on the drawing sheet, because if we start attempting drawing directly on the thermocol sheet without any preconceived idea, the design may end up in hodgepodge and chaotic composition. Rubbing of the lines on thin thermocol sheet is difficult, as the surface is rough and textured. The original design helps in saving time and errors which one can find on the thermocol sheet. Use the pencil gently and draw lines quickly in freehand style. I place another squarish thermocol sheet equal in size to the first thermocol sheet and draw bold circular lines as already drawn on the first sheet, and cut it with the help of a pointed cutter. I correct the circular shape as seen below. Use pointed cutter, as it helps in cutting even small shapes correctly, but it should be kept in mind that it does not cut the lower sheet. In this process, shapes are cut out of this corner circular piece of thermocol sheet as seen in the design. This procedure requires practice and keen observation, otherwise the cut out shapes will not match the original design. Take a glue gun and apply glue on the back side of the shapes which are to be pasted on the first thermocol sheet according to the design. Each shape has to be cut perfectly and paste it properly. According to American poet and philosopher Henry David Thoreau, this world is but a canvas to our imagination. To create negative spaces, some cutouts are kept out and pasted on another similar shape to be pasted in raised form. Now we have different levels of raised surfaces. Application of cutout shapes is used to create layers and add interest to the mural design. Glue should be expressly applied, as overuse will mess up the overall look with smudges and ugly patches. It will also spoil your hands. I continue cutting and pasting different shapes which are present in the original design. Round and oval shapes should be cut slowly. According to eminent Dutch artist Piet Mondrian, the only problem in art is to achieve a balance between subjective and objective. The more accurately you cut the shapes, the better final product will emerge. Each shape should be observed on the original design, and cutout should match the original shapes. And I emphasize that keen observation is the key to this process. Thermocol sheets can be placed on the original design and marked for cutting. Triangle and straight lines are easy to cut, while the other round and circular shapes need precision while cutting. Extra material can be cut and kept aside so that there is no confusion of cutout shapes laying on the table where you are working. Similar process is followed while cutting the other shapes in the design. According to eminent American realist painter and printmaker Edward Hopper, no amount of skillful imagination can replace the essential element of imagination. An eminent American naturalist, author, and philosopher, John Muir, has rightly said, "The power of imagination makes us infinite." You see here that I have continued to raise the other shapes by pasting over the first shape. It gives a three-dimensional effect to the thermocool mural design. Now larger shapes are being cut and pasted. According to legendary Italian painter Leonardo da Vinci, the painter has the universe in his mind and hands. The thermocool sheet should be cut in single stroke, as repeated pressure on the pointed cutter will spoil the shape of the forms and will also cut through the lower sheet. Use a thin thermocool sheet, as thick sheets cannot be cut easily and shapes are distorted. According to renowned American author and scholar Phil Cousinho, inspiration comes and goes. Creativity is the result of practice. Addition and subtraction of forms and shapes present a good sense of relief work. According to eminent American artist and educator Corita Kent, creativity belongs to the artist in each of us. To create means to relate. The root meaning of the word art is to fit together, and we all do this every day. Not all of us are painters, but we are all artists. Each time we fit things together, we are creating, whether it is to make a loaf of bread, a child, a day. Cutting of exact shapes requires a lot of practice and depends upon the artist. He or she uses the pointed cutter. Thin slices of thermocool surface can be removed with a pointed cutter to give more interesting depressions and slant shapes. According to renowned Polish sculptor and fiber artist Magdalena Abakanowicz, art will remain the most astonishing activity of mankind, born out of struggle between wisdom and madness, between dream and reality in our mind. The play of light and shade falling on the slanting lines and grooves add charming aesthetic value to the surface. According to legendary Italian painter Leonardo da Vinci, painting is poetry that is seen rather than felt, and poetry is painting that is felt rather than seen. Gently cut the surface with slanted pointed cutter to create groove-like textures. According to renowned Canadian writer and founder of Creativity at Work, Linda Nyman, art provides an opportunity for kaleidoscopic thinking. Each time we shift the lens of our perceptions, we gain perspectives and new opportunities for innovation. By softening and toning the sharp contours, make a design more appealing. While slicing the thermocol sheet to remove thin layers, keep the pointed cutter parallel to the surface of the thermocol mural, otherwise it can cut deeper if the pointed cutter is used in a standing position. This process can be defined as peeling and slicing, which can be used on such delicate materials as thermocol. Artists should practice this process before mastering it on other spare thermocol sheets. badly handled pointed cutter will destroy the thermocol mural. Always hold the thermocol sheet with left hand and use the pointed cutter gently without pushing it too hard. Haste makes waste in this process. Now rub the sliced shapes with a soft sandpaper to round up the contours. It will remove the slice marks from the grooves, and the thermocol surface will give the well chiseled look, removing rough patches. Sandpaper should be gently applied on all sliced surface on the thermocol mural. Heated glue gun or any other similar tool is used to create organic textural surface. According to eminent American author Napoleon Hill, first comes thought, then organization of that thought into ideas and plans, then transformation of those plans into reality. The beginning, as you will observe, is in your imagination. He pointed head of the tool gently carves the surface and creates an appealing texture. This unusual texture has enhanced the very look of the thermocol mural by adding a new dimension. As already determined in original design on drawing sheet, this free-flowing texture is added to other predetermined areas. According to renowned Canadian writer and founder of Creativity at Work, Linda Nyman, art making has an alchemical effect on the imagination. It awakens the senses and sharpens insights, teaching us to think in symbols, metaphors, and to decode complexity, so we can perceive the world in new ways. Another style of texture is created by me on some shapes or the elements of the thermocol mural by cutting small slanting shapes, making small grooves. Eminent artist and painter Paul Cézanne has rightly said, "Painting, like any art, comprises a technique, a workmanlike handling of material. But the accuracy of a tone and the fictitious combination of effects depend entirely on the choice made by the artist." Variety of textures is instrumental in giving an appealing look. According to eminent Swiss architect, painter and artist Max Bill, "I endeavor to make a picture, for instance, exert a positive influence on the observer by its coloring, mood and compositional idea, encouraging, say, activation, tranquilization, concentration or harmony. This process is repeated on the other raised surfaces as preconceived in our design, slicing and removing the extra material cutouts of the shapes." A broad cutter is of no use, hence use only thin and pointed sharp cutter. The legendary artist Paul Cézanne has summed up in few words the following viewpoint: "Design and color are not distinct and separate. As one paints, one draws. The more the colors harmonize, the more the design takes form. When color is at its richest, form is at its fullest." more surfaces are covered in this pattern. According to renowned Polish sculptor and fiber artist Magdalena Abakanowicz, art will remain the most astonishing activity of mankind, born out of struggle between wisdom and madness, between dream and reality in our mind. An artist can use his or her creativity, ingenuity, and keep on creating variety of textures, as more the textures, more the aesthetic appeal of the relief mural. Flat surfaces look monotonous and sharp. Use the tip of the pointed cutter effectively to make wedge-like grooves. This way, all the elements of the composition get well or offer a cohesive and well-balanced look to the composition, where different elements complement each other. Remaining areas are covered with free-flowing haphazard texture with a glue gun. This gives a baton metal-like effect to the surface of the thermocol mural design. Even small straight lines can be drawn freely with glue gun to create another interesting texture. Even the round and oval shapes are softened and rounded with the pointed cutter, and sandpaper is applied on them to smoothen the surface. The straight lines drawn earlier have been rounded and smoothened by using a small piece of sandpaper. Thank you.